Your son is a failure, he's barely passing my class, and with grades like this, I'm just not sure what kind of future he's gonna have.
What do you have to say for yourself? You're supposed to graduate this year, listen to Mr. Steven. What kind of future do you think you're gonna have?
With all due respect, don't call me a failure. Failure is an event, not a person. And you talk about the future, Mr. Steven. Yes. But you are not preparing us for that.
Excuse me.
Just listen to what I'm saying. This should be good. Would you agree that in the future most careers will become automated?
Yes.
So, the people who succeed will have to be curious, innovative, with resilience, to adapt to new changes.
What's your point,
Mr. Steven? The focus in this school is not on that, it is on regurgitating information and tests taking, and that is just real. But in today's world, creativity is the most important leadership skill.
Oh, that's how you feel?
You don't have to believe me, but maybe you will believe the 1,500 executives who recently said creativity is the most important leadership skill. See, pretty soon, no one will be hired because of what they know, because who cares what you know, or if you have memorized, the fact we have got Google. In the future, people will be hired because of what they can do with their knowledge. Can they creatively solve real-world problems? Not just follow instructions or direction. That's why I'm stressed, because these robotic tasks we learned in school should stop. Because no one can do a robot's job better than a robot. The billionaire founder of Alibaba, Jack Ma, said that we should not compete with artificial intelligence, but instead focus on developing unique human intelligence. You're gonna find a lot of people graduating out of your class right into the unemployment line. See, many top companies today don't look at grades.
You are right, son.
So I say this with unease and sorrow. If you continue to teach today as you taught yesterday, then you rob us students of tomorrow, Mr. Steven. I'm gonna keep it real with you. Sometimes sitting in your class is tough. I'm constantly thinking that if I don't look up at the clock, maybe it will speed up. So I listen to you, do my work and pay attention, feeling like an hour had to have gone by, but it was only 3 minutes. So if you wonder why we're bored in class, look, if you want to get the kid to hate reading, give them this, a school textbook. Remember, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make them drink. And to that I say, no. Firstly, you could put salt in that horse's hay and make them thirsty.
See, I never knew you can speak like that.
I mean no disrespect, you have the most important job on this planet. You build, create and save lives. But if you really care about my future, like you say, then you have to fully commit and ask yourself, honestly, how do I prepare a child for a future that doesn't yet exist?
Oh, is this my student for sure?
There you come again.
I've never heard you speak like that before. I didn't know, but I'm gonna reach out to administration and try to change some things. You have my word.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Steven.
Guys, thanks for watching this video till the end. I remain Okit Steven. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment and also subscribe for more videos on this channel.